Unless you're using 50 GI, but then you have slower RPM. Wow, this gun is so good now. It's so good. Using secondary. Good player. So hello gamers and welcome back to another video. So today I'm going to be showing you the top 10 fastest killing guns in Phantom Forces. If you guys didn't know, time to kill is how fast you are able to eliminate an opponent. And there are some very, very quick killing guns in this game. So today I'm going to be counting down the top 10 fastest ones. Make sure to like and subscribe. If you're new, please check if you're subscribed down below. It really helps out a lot if you actually subscribe. But yeah, this is the C882 with 7.62. It can kill in 0.08 seconds because it has 900 RPM and can two shot to the head. So to the body, it's going to be more like, you know, 0.1 seconds. Pretty good, right? But to the head, it's going to be like even faster, as you can see. This gun seems really, really good on paper, but it does have a bunch of downsides. The recoil is pretty bad. The ranges are pretty bad. It doesn't really two shot that far, but TTK is not bad at all. The problem with it is that it's only got 900 RPM. And if you really think about it, Colt SMG is a three shot to the body to farther than this is. And sure, this can two shot headshot, but it's not going to always happen with the recoil. So is it a great gun? No, it's a pretty good gun though. It does kill really, really quickly, as you can see. But at the number 9 spot, we have a gun known as the Rama 1130. The Rama, by default, doesn't have a very great time to kill. It's 0.12, which is pretty good, but not great. Then if you run 380 ACP, you get 0.06, and you're like, how is that even possible? Well, basically, it goes from being a 4-shot to the body down to a 3-shot body and 2-shot headshot, but gets the same RPM. It falls off pretty hard. The recoil is fine. This is with muzzle boosters, so just keep that in mind, but it is 0.06 overall, which is really great TTK, I'm not gonna lie. Problem with it is, of course, it only has 12 bullets, and yeah, it reloads really quickly, but 12 bullets in a magazine, not that great. However, if you're really accurate and you're engaging only one target at a time, it becomes really, really good because you get a reload off between every single engagement. When you engage multiple targets simultaneously, you'll see this gun start to really fall off, unless they're literally like 1 foot away from each other or you have amazing aim. But it does reload really, really quickly, and you can just use a secondary. Good player. I don't really run 380 ACP, I'm not gonna lie. I prefer to have 80 bullets and just have a slower time to kill. But if you want an insanely fast time to kill, you can't really go wrong with this one. Very, very good. That's why it's number 9. Because it can kill so quickly. Next up, we have an even faster killing gun, which is the MG3 KWS. It says 0.06, but that's not entirely true, because Rama 380 ACP is 0.06 with 950 RPM, and this is 1,000, so it's a little bit faster, not by a ton, and you're probably like, okay, Colt SMG has 1,000, right? Well, Colt SMG can't two-shot unless you're using 50 GI, but then you have slower RPM. Wow, this gun is so good now. It's so good. The faster reload on this gun just makes it so good. Like, I actually enjoy using it now. And you can't really go wrong with the TTK on it. It just kills so quickly. This is why I think the M60 is the worst LMG now. I used to think it was the MG3, but like, the reload buff is just so nice because I can just beam people like this and then just, you know, reload really quickly. This does have a little bit faster RPM, so it's not very much more time to kill. But here's the thing about it. It actually has really, really good ranges. So the 2-hit kill range is actually going to be more like 3-4 times as far. Maybe not 4, but like a bit farther, which is really helpful for a gun like this. And it also has a 5-hit kill min, which means it will always be like pretty decent damage. You know, it's not going to be amazing damage, but 38 to 23 damage is pretty good. Next up though, we have an even faster gun, which is going to go to the MAC-10. Now the MAC-10 has 1090 RPM and can also two shot to the head. This one falls off a lot harder than something like the MG3, and the recoil is a lot higher. However, it just fires a little bit faster, just a tiny bit faster. And you're probably like, okay, why am I not running 9mm conversion, right? Well, that doesn't have a 2-hit kill or a 3-hit kill body. It does have 1,300 RPM, but the hits to kill is usually more important than just straight up RPM. If you notice, some of the highest RPM guns in the game don't really have the best TTK. Like the Tech 9, you'd expect it to have amazing TTK, but it can't really, you know, kill in that many shots. It's gonna be like a 4-shot to the head and like a 5-shot to the body. It has a 0.08, which is really, really good, but it's not that great when you consider like the MP1911 has a 0.09 with 9mm and a 0.06 without 9mm. So that's why I don't really recommend the Tech 9 at all. Regardless, at number 6, we have a machine pistol, and this is actually not going to be going to the MP1911. It's a very, very fast killing gun. However, the Micro Uzi with the Strike 3 ammo type has amazing TTK. I'm putting this and a gun that has exactly the same TTK in different spots because of a couple of reasons. First off, this doesn't actually have the theoretical TTK. And the reason for that is it just doesn't really have the best spread or ranges. It has awful spread and awful ranges. It can only two-shot if every single pellet hits to 15 studs. And after that, not really. And yeah, the spread is very, very bad. Theoretically, it does have like a 0.06, 0.05, I think, time to kill, which is really incredible, you know? It says 0.25, but that's absolutely not true. The reason for that is because it doesn't really multiply damage with shotgun conversions too well. And so the game gets confused and goes, okay, this gun does like 17 damage, so clearly the TTK isn't very good. But actually it is, but actually it's not because it's a shotgun. So you're not really gonna hit that many pellets, but if you do, as you can see, that time to kill there was incredible. The fact that you can absolutely vaporize like that, and also it's a shotgun, so you don't really gotta aim, makes it a very, very good, only very CQC gun. And as you can see, like, I'm talking very CQC. Even there, that wasn't really the effective range of the gun. Even here, not that effective. You gotta basically barrel stuff with it, which is cool as a concept. Like, this kind of combat, I guess. I only got two shots. Can I get a kill? Hold on. Come on, dude. Shh. No! So number five, we have the Chris Vector, which has the same TTK. And some of you guys may be thinking, okay, 0.1, that's not very good. Like, that's very, very good. But not great for this video. Well, 45 Super gives it a two-shot headshot, which will reduce your TTK from 0.1 to 0.05. It's only to the head, but actually you can hit those two shots because the recoil on the Vector, it's pretty low, and you can easily hit the three shots to the body in close range. It is an incredible gun. The Chris Vector is probably my favorite automatic gun in the entire game. I think it's amazing. The fire rate is insane, and honestly, the recoil is not bad at all. In my opinion, it's like the best PDW for me, because I know the Colt SMG is a little bit better objectively, and I do have like 1500 on the Colt SMG, but I just like this gun more, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, buddy. So yeah, the minimum time to kill of this gun is 0.05 with 45 Super, which I do recommend. It will be nerfing it pretty soon, but like not by a ton. It'll still have about... Wow. As you can see from there, that was a two-shot headshot. I beamed him. Is it a bit of a difficult gun to use? I guess, but like, I'm not gonna lie. The Vector is... not that difficult. That nade was gonna kill me though. If you're good with it and you can hit your shots and not basically dump a magazine on every single kill, it will basically become like an unbeatable gun, I'm not gonna lie. But then we have an even faster gun, is the M231 carbine barrel M855 Patriot. This gun is a bit of a menace. It's not actually that great with this setup, I'm not gonna lie. If you run like X-Ring, I think, and then run the chainsaw grip, it has very, very good hip fire, but it doesn't two shot to the head, so it's not really gonna go in the video. But this has a 0.05 second time to kill. It has 25 more RPM than the Vector, so it does have a faster TTK than the Vector, but you just can't hit your stuff, so I don't really like recommend this or anything. I don't really like the gun. I just don't like the M231. I was fine with the old one because, you know, it was so broken, but I wasn't like a fan of it or anything. I was always more of a fan of the Vector. Here was my setup before. Oh, it's got so much recoil, right? Not really, like, you can just pull it down. In close range, this was a really busted gun. The TTK is very, very fast with M855 and the short barrel. But do I like it? Not really. But that's not why it's going in the video. The reason it's going in the video is, of course, because it kills so fast. And the default gun still kills pretty quickly. It only has a 4-hit kill, but, like, it has 1,225 RPM, so it doesn't really matter. Not really, not that much. I'm surprised more people aren't still using this. You know, the M855 is good and all, but like, I much prefer the handling of this one, and it still kills really quickly. But now we're getting on to some of the fastest TTK guns you have ever seen. At number three, we have the Tommy gun. And you're like, okay, 0.08, that's pretty good. But what if I told you that with 1919, it can go down to 0.04? That's incredible. That TTK is incredible. The problem with it is that it's got some recoil, but I'm gonna be real, it's not that bad for the absolute damage that this gun can put out. Got him. This gun has a 2.1 second reload, which is pretty good. Only got 20 rounds, however, it just does a ton of damage. 37 to the body and like 53 to the head or something. That is actually great. And also, it can two-shot to like 60 studs, which is really good as well. If you think about it, on paper, this is a better Chris Vector. It actually has better damage, better ranges, a faster reload, more reserve ammo. The only downside about it is really that it doesn't have quite as good velocity, and of course, it's got this much recoil. But overall, it is a very great conversion. I don't see anybody really using it, and I don't really know why, because the M231 was so popular. This has like better damage output than the old M231 did. It's just... It kills so quickly, I don't understand. But at number two, we have an assault rifle, and it's a very low rank one as well. It's the AN-94. In 0.1 seconds is pretty good, but it actually has an 1800, that's two shots, RPM burst, and can two-shot head with 7.62. This has technically a 0.03 second time to kill. That is 1/33rd of a second. So basically, you can theoretically kill 33 people with the RPM that this can put out. However, it is a burst, and it doesn't fire at that speed after those initial two shots. Also, the gun's got recoil and stuff, but like, it's kind of insane that it can do this. And then after this, it goes to a 600 RPM auto, which is pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. Like, it has that initial burst, and if you hit those two shots, it's an instant kill, basically. But after that, it does have a very nice damage full auto mode, which makes it an overall not bad gun. I'm not gonna lie. If you're going off of non-instant time to kill, this is the fastest in the game. 0.03, you're not gonna really beat that anytime soon. However, if you're going off of technical time to kill and stuff, there are two options that are a lot faster. First off, the AF-2011, which has a 999,000 RPM burst. You basically can't tell. It's like an instant burst. But technically speaking, yes, this can instant kill, basically. It's like 0.00000001 seconds. And the other option, of course, would be shotgun, sniper rifles, and anything that can one-shot, which are 0.00. They're instant kills. In my opinion, it does count. And if you're not going to go off of AF-2011, then it's, of course, going to be the AN-94 instant burst, which you can't really hit those basically instant kills too much. But the AF-2011, yeah, you just got to hit a single headshot. Well, technically two headshots, you know, but it's basically one single shot. Really up to you guys. I'd say like this is the fastest in the game, but not by miss. But I really want to try to hit a instant burst kill with this. Ooh, I have to get like super close. Ooh. Dang it, that was right outside of the range. And I spawned up here. Okay, listen, I'm gonna end the video here. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to like and subscribe. Comment down below your favorite very fast time to kill gun. If I forgot one as well, let me know. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.